My name is Fred Matthews. I'm a full professor at San Jose State. I came here 23 years ago with my partner, Gary Masters.
Gary Masters, professor of dance, San Jose State.
Well, I think there's a seriousness and a sensitivity. It's interesting, many of our students who come in at 18 have had only ballet or jazz. And I've always maintained it's very unusual for there to be programs in modern dance for people under 18. And I think that's partially because it takes a certain amount of maturity to think that you'd be interested in something that's in a sense, abstract. Ballet, you can look and you can see the beauty of the movement, you can see the virtuosity. In jazz, you can see the sensual, you can see the spectacular, you can see the energy and the rhythm. But I think modern dancers are looking inside. Martha Graham said it beautifully. She said choreography, and she meant contemporary choreography, or modern, is a revelation of the inner landscape. And I think that's the desire to understand who you are and to reveal that. And you to understand who you are in relationship to the rest of the world.
When Isadora, broke all the rules, and Ted Chandru, St. Denis were doing things, and then the pioneers, Graham and Humphrey Moe and others, the modern dance was really personalizing dance. It was really dance of the individual human being. And so every dancer who creates something has a different point of view about how those ideas manifest themselves in movement. Certainly different from what the pioneers established and what Jose continued and people like him. But of course, that's just the continuation of an art form. I mean, it develops, it changes. It's always in a state of evolution. And I think for Doris and Charles and Jose, one of the reasons they didn't codify the technique was because they believed that would constrict it from growing, from changing. And even though all of us who teach Limon technique or style, and there's a whole debate within the family whether it's a style or a technique or blah blah blah, but is that we all teach differently. But that was one of the premises.
Doris Humphrey, famous choreographer, always said, you have to know your world. You have to be aware of your world, and you have to live in your world. And I think frequently modern dancers, I think, are political. In other words, it's not the fantasy that goes behind children loving ballet, or even the kind of energy that attracts a young person to jazz. It's something deeper.
right now I think we're in a period of extreme athleticism. Some of it pushed to the max by television. So you think you can dance and dance with the stars. It's not that they discovered athleticism by any means. It's always been there. We talk about this in history that, you know, really dancers are a conglomerate. You know, we are dancers, we are athletes, we are musicians, and we have to be theater people. And the great ones are all of those things.
There are varying degrees of content. You know, what's so interesting in the arts, especially dance and painting, is that there's, it just happens in music also, that there's this constant circle, and here we have content and here we have form. And as far as I'm concerned, Lamon found a beautiful balance between those two. But what happens is that you know, form maybe starts to become more important. That's what began to happen at the sort of as I was arriving in New York. Form was becoming more important, and content was going away. And with minimalism, form became the end in itself. Okay. And that was a very popular movement in dance. And we still are sort of reaping the benefits of it in a way.
There is this athleticism going on where it's just about movement and how many more strange new things can we create, which is great. But I think because of, you know, the real drama that's happening in our world, I think people are starting to think about that. And there are artists who are putting that in their work again. Not that it ever went away, but it just was less prominent.
I want to change something in your school. So you're standing there, you do this thing to, you do this seesaw,
right?
And I think you have to be in some sort of undertow that actually keeps you moving downstage, and then, I think to just stop there, it doesn't make sense for me anymore. Like, taking that mountain, yeah, there has to be this, I think, some sort of idea, because the last bit really does look like an ocean. So I think that you have to introduce that idea.
How fulfilling has dance been for you in your life?
I don't think I could say. It's every dream I could have dreamed. An opportunity to express myself emotionally, physically, intellectually, spiritually. We may have to stop for a moment.
It's okay.